Hey friends, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Victoria and today we are going to be doing my July wrap up. It's August now. I don't know how that happened, where the summer went. I need it to stop. I do not want the fall yet. I want more summer, although it is 95 degrees outside right now. So like summer, but like a little bit cooler, or summer with AC. So I had a pretty good reading month in July. I read 24 books and one DNF, so 25 total entries in my spreadsheet. And I feel pretty good about that. I was very busy in July. I went on 3 different vacations and I just got back from a PolyCon like 2 days ago. Yeah, I got back on Monday. It's Wednesday now. It was amazing. I had a great time. There were some snafus with the actual event itself, but overall for me, they didn't really impact me. I had a great time. I got all of my books signed that I wanted to. I bought more books than I thought I was going to. A book haul will be coming. I had to have my friend mail my books to me. So when my books get to me, I will be doing a book haul. I got to meet some amazing BookTubers that I love and we got to hang out and it was great. Tori from Novel Life, Kerry from Books for Romance, Jess from Peace Love Books, Lacey from Lacey Book Lovers, so many people, oh my gosh. Samantha from Books with Samantha, Desiree from Genki Reader, lots of people. It was great. I had a great time. And I did actually get some reading done while I was there, which was good for me. So we are going to start with my star ratings that I had this month. I ended up having 6 5-star reads, 2 4.5 stars, 10 4 stars, 4 3.5 stars, 1 3 star, 1 2.5 star, and my average was about 3.95. That's pretty good. I had no rereads this month, so I had 6 brand new 5-star reads, which was great. I had 10 new to me authors, which I was so happy about. I read 18 audiobooks and 7 ebooks. 9 were ones that I owned and 16 were from my subscription services. So I'm really using my subscription services, which is great. And I, like I said, feel really good about it. So I am going to wrap up the books that I read in the second half of July. The first half of July, I think I read 8 books. I will link the mid-month wrap up in a description or in the cards. So go watch that if you missed it. But other than that, I'm gonna get right into the books that I read in the second half of July. So the first one that I read was actually for a reading vlog and it was my reading books that my favorite BookTubers recommend, part 2. And the first book that I read for that vlog was The Devil's Submission by Nicola Davidson, which is was recommended to me by Rachel from Rachel Reads and Sings, and I really liked this book. I gave it 4 stars. It's a historical, it's a novella, it's steamy, it was great. The it's a marriage in trouble, which I was surprised with. I don't usually like marriage in trouble, but Nicola Davidson did a great job and I ended up really enjoying this book, so much so that I read the second, or actually it was the third one because The Devil's Submission is the second one. So I read the third book in the series, which is The Seduction of Viscount Vice, and that one is a second chance romance, which I also don't usually like, but I gave it 4.5 stars. It's also like novella short length. It's a historical. I loved it. It is a, like I said, second chance romance. The characters, Mari, she and Vice had a sort of love affair when they were younger, and then Mari disappeared, and Vice always thought that she like used him. And now it's years later and Vice runs into Mari again and it's super surprising for him because he thought she was dead. And so they end up reconnecting and I really, really loved it. Then I read Blood Bonds by Jay Bree. This is the third book in the Bonds That Tie series, which is a paranormal romance, sort of Fated Mates series. And this is book 3, so I can't say a lot about it. I did read book 1 and 2 in the first half of the month, but it is the first book in the series, or the overall series, is a paranormal series. The heroine is incredibly powerful, and she has these 5 five? Yes, I think five. Five bonds, which are basically her like fated people that she's supposed to be with. It is a reverse harem. And it's super addictive, the series. It's like crazy addictive. And I ended up reading half of the fourth book in July also, but it's not included on here because I never finished it because I needed the audiobook. So I'm trying to wait until the audiobook comes out because these books have really big cliffhangers at the end of them and you just get really frustrated. But I really, really loved it. And I would definitely recommend the series. Then the next two books that I read were also for that reading BookTubers recommendations vlog. I read Lucian by Bethany Chris under Tori's recommendation, and I absolutely loved it. Gave it 5 stars. Has a mafia romance, and it's insta love, but done in a great way. And then I read For Real by Alexis Hall on Bree's recommendation, and I also gave that one 5 stars. And I have like a whole philosophical brain going crazy clip in that reading vlog because I was like so emotionally like changed and distraught over that book. So I would very much recommend it. That one. It like really, really makes you think about like your life and everything. Then I read Tempt Me by K.A. Tucker. This is book one in the Wolf Hotel series. I really wanted to read book two right after I finished this one, but then I went on vacation and my subscription services wouldn't work. So I will end up going back to this series and finishing the series. I will be doing a vlog for it, probably. This one is a billionaire romance. The heroine is from like small town in the South, and she finds out that her boyfriend, who she's supposed to get married to, who she's been with for her entire life, who her entire small town expects her to marry, she finds him cheating on her. And she doesn't believe in sex before marriage, and she is very like involved in her church and all that stuff. And she finds out her boyfriend's cheating on her, and her like whole family and her whole community are like, you just gotta let him explore and then he'll come back to you. Like, men are weaker with their temptations, and it made me mad. And then she decides she needs to get the hell out of her small town, and so she takes a job with Wolf Hotels, where she gets sent to Alaska and meets the owner of Wolf Hotels and has a romance with him. And it's really good. I gave it 4 stars. I really liked it. It was definitely like a really good start to the series, so I do have to really continue to get like full thoughts on everything because it is a series that you like have to read in order. It does not end on a HEA. So like the whole series ends on an HEA, but each book doesn't. That makes sense. Then I read Not So Perfect Omega by Maya Nicole. This one I saw Christy from Read Between the Wines talk about on TikTok, and I was like in a very not sure what I wanted mood, and this just caught my interest. Sounded really good. It is an Omegaverse reverse harem. And I really liked it. I gave it 4 stars. The heroine does not want to be placed with a pack. She and her twin sister go to this like Omega school, and at the graduation of the school they're supposed to get placed with a pack, and so she decides that she doesn't want to get placed with a pack, and so she like checks that she doesn't want to be. And then her sister is like prize Omega. She's like very follows all the rules and all this thing, and everyone thinks that she's gonna get placed with like a perfect pack. Well, then on placement day, the sister, the heroine, who doesn't want to be placed with the pack, gets placed with a pack that she did not want to be placed with, and her sister gets placed with nobody. So, crazy pants. And then she arrives at the pack's house, and the pack think that she's her sister. And it's very interesting, and I actually really liked it. I had a great time with it. So it was very like low stakes, fun, like spicy Omegaverse. I liked it. Then I read The Guy from That One Summer by Cece Monroe. This one is like a 35 page novella. It was fine. It was 3.5 stars. It was basically just like smut. There wasn't really like a lot to it. It was just sex. And it was, that was fine. Then I did another reading vlog where I did a read books while I was on vacation in the Adirondack Mountains. And the first book that I read for that reading vlog was Faking with Benefits by Lily Gold. This one is a contemporary reverse harem. She is their neighbor and also their, they like fake date. So the three guys run this podcast called Three Single Guys or something. And the podcast starts getting questions like, what gives you the right to give dating advice? So they decide to do this experiment where they put their dating advice to the test and try and help their neighbor get a date. And so they decide to fake date their neighbor in order to teach her how to date better, basically. I enjoyed it. I gave it 4 stars. It was way too long. Like, it was way longer than it needed to be, and that was like my main issue with it. It was like almost 600 pages and just did not need to be. But it was fine other than that. I mean, like, it wasn't like a favorite. It wasn't special in any way. Then in that same reading vlog, I read Rogue by Eden Finley. This is book 2 in the Mike Bravo Ops series. This series follows military contractors, private military contractors, and it's MM. So in this one, it is one night stand enemies to lovers situation. So the main hero in this is the actual owner of Mike Bravo, and his name is Trav, and he has a one night stand with a guy, and then that guy later on that day arrests him. Turns out that guy was a DEA agent and arrests Trav in like a misunderstanding. And so throughout the years after that, they don't really they can't stand each other. They don't get along very well, but they do end up running into each other a lot and like doing favors for each other, like career-wise. So then it's years later and Dylan, who is the DEA agent, he is in some trouble with work. His superior officer is a dirty cop, and so he is on the run, and he goes to Trav for help, and then Trav has to help and hide him, and they end up falling in love. And I liked it. It was really cute. I gave it 4 stars. Then in that same reading vlog, I read Captive of the Horde King by Zoe Draven. This is a alien romance. The heroine's brother, the heroine and her brother are human, and they live on this planet, and the planet is run by this, like, group of aliens. And the heroine's brother does something that is, like, against the rules of these, like, alien rulers on the planet. And so one of the, like, basically heads of their, like, military shows up in their encampment, and the heroine is like, please don't hurt my brother, I'll go with you and be your captive if you spare my brother. And the Horde King, I can't remember his name, he is basically like, yeah, sounds good, I'll take you. And she thinks that he's taking her to be his slave, and he is actually taking her to be his queen. And it's basically like, if you've ever seen Game of Thrones, it's very like Khal Drogo and Khaleesi. And I loved it. I loved it. I gave it 5 stars. It was fantastic. Then after that, I read Hush Hush by Lucia Franco. And this one, I really liked the beginning of it. And then it kind of fell apart for me. And so I ended up giving it 3 stars. It's a best friend's dad romance, and the heroine ends up going into sort of like being a sex worker, and she basically is an escort, and she gets paired with this guy who she has a very strong connection with, and turns out that that guy ends up being her best friend's dad. And There is cheating in this book, which I was one of the big things that I didn't like about it. There was also, like it was cheating for no reason, you know, if that makes sense. Like, obviously there's never a reason for cheating, but the heroine didn't even like her boyfriend. I didn't understand why she didn't just break up with him. It made no sense to me. Like, it was like useless cheating. It had no impact on the plot or anything. Like, she did not need to be with him. And there were just some other, it was just not my favorite. And I ended up having issues with it. And I didn't love the ending. Then I read Voyeur by Fiona Cole. This is a student teacher romance. And the heroine works at a club where it's like a kink club, but it's for people to watch. So like the people who work there do like performances based off of what the members want to see. And so she works there, and the guy that ends up being watching her is her teacher, and they end up falling in love. And I enjoyed it, but I didn't, it was one of those ones where as soon as they got together, he was like super jealous and like adamant that she needed to quit this club. And I just, it just frustrated me. He looked down on her after they got together for working at this club, but they had met at this club and he had been a member of it. So it just didn't, it bothered me a lot, the hero in this book. I liked the heroine, but the hero, I just didn't understand his jealousy issues. Like, I thought that they were irritating. So I gave it 3.5 stars. This is also, there is a trigger warning in here for, childhood sexual assault. The hero was assaulted as a child, so please be aware of that going in, because I didn't read anything about it beforehand, so I was a little blindsided by that. Then I DNF'd. The one DNF that I had was Promises and Pomegranates by Sav R. Miller. This one I DNF'd very early on. I was only like 10-15% into it, and I felt like I was like fully dropped into the story. Like, I didn't really understand what was going on. Like, there was no intro or anything, and it just wasn't catching my attention, and I wasn't interested in it, and I didn't really love the way the writing was, and I just couldn't connect to it, so I just DNF'd it. Then I read The Bribe by Willa Nash. This is book one in her Calamity Montana series. And this one I really liked. I gave it 4 stars. This one is about a heroine who is a famous pop star. And she moves to Calamity, Montana and dyes her hair and is trying to hide out. And she ends up meeting the town sheriff and having a romance with him, but she is like running from things in Nashville and like trying to hide out, and so there is like some secrets and like there is like a suspense aspect of it, which makes sense because it's Devney Perry, so there usually is at least some sort of like suspenseful element to her books. But I enjoyed it. It's was just really fun and enjoyable, and just like what I needed in the moment, and it made me want to read the rest of the series, and I liked it. Then I read Fair Catch by Candy Steiner. This one I gave 4.5 stars. I liked Blindside better, but Fair Catch was still very good. I really, really liked Riley, which was like my main reason for reading it, because I liked her in Blindside too. It is a brother's best friend, enemies to lovers situation, and they're also roommates. There was one thing conflict-wise in this book that kind of bothered me. It was one of those things where like they kind of like make things like jump out of proportion and like don't take the time to listen and like understand what actually happened. And those kind of conflicts always kind of bother me. So that was like the one thing that made it not 5 stars, but I still really, really loved it, and I'm really happy I read it. The last book that I read is The Bluff by Willa Nash, which is actually book 2 to The Bribe. and book two in Calamity Montana series. And this one is a contemporary marriage of convenience. And the heroine is the best friend of the girl Lucy from the first book. And so she's new to Calamity, moves into town to follow Lucy because they've always lived in the same place. And she meets Rhys Huxley, who is a reclusive artist and also a single dad. He was in prison when his ex-wife gave birth, and he didn't even know that he had a child until after he got out of prison. It was a really horrible situation, and I really felt bad for him because his ex-wife was like a bitch. And so his daughter, he and his daughter have become really close over the years, but his ex-wife refuses to let him see the daughter and is like really manipulative. And her new husband is like a lawyer and like always keeps Huxley from having any sort of like visitation with his daughter. And basically Hux's lawyer says that if he had a long-term girlfriend or a wife, that he would probably have a better chance of gaining some sort of custody. And so Everly, who had just had a one-night stand with Hux, overhears this and is basically like, yo, I'll marry you. And so they get married, and in order to get custody or get partial custody of Huxley's daughter. I really liked it. I liked it better than book one, but I still gave it 4 stars, but I did like it better than book one. So it was a higher 4 stars. And I'm already reading the third book in the series in August. I already started it. So, so that's going well. But that was the last book that I read in July. I went through all of those very quickly, so I'm really sorry about that. But that is going to be it for this video. So please let me know down in the comments what your favorite book that you read in July was. My favorites that I read were probably Blindside by Candy Steiner, Redeemed by Lauren Asher, and The Bride Goes Rogue by Joanna Shoup, I think, are going to be my top three. And my least favorite book that I read in July was The Devil You Know by Elizabeth O'Rourke, just so you know. But that's going to be it. So thank you so much for watching. Please like this video if you liked it, and subscribe and stick around so you can see more from me. But that's going to be it. So I hope you have a great day. Bye.